My name is Jade Griffin. I'm 11 years old, and I live in Gadsden, Alabama.
Hi, my name is Michael Lake. I'm 27 years old, and I'm from Coleman, Alabama.
Hey, my name is Jaleel Alford. I'm 17, and I'm from Longbird, North Carolina.
My name is Shalace Lake. I'm 26 years old, and I'm from Gadsden, Alabama.
When I was born, the doctors diagnosed me with sickle cell anemia. From then on, I was in and out of the hospital sick, not able to do what other kids did.
My mom and dad had me at 15 and 16 years old.
I came from a broken family. My mom was in and out of 5 marriages. Out of 5 fathers, not one of them took initiative to actually be a real father.
At a young age, I dabbled in a lot of perversion, and I experimented with homosexuality.
My father was an addict, so he was absent. He wasn't in my life. One of my stepdads beat my mom, and I saw it daily. He also was an addict. Another one of my stepdads molested me when I was 13 years old.
As I got a little older, I was introduced to pornography by an older cousin of mine.
Everything was great until I was 4 years old when my dad got addicted to drugs. He would leave all the time and no one would tell me why.
One day I was caught in the act and my dad came in and he explained it to me that it was against God and it was against nature and against his word. Because I respected my dad so much, I listened and I stopped. But when we moved from California to Alabama, I just traded one perversion for the other and I went after every girl I could find.
It wasn't long until I was addicted.
I also struggled with pornography for several years. It was a generational thing. It was a generational curse that I had to break, that had to stop with me.
My dad would beat my mom and throw stuff, and there would be times I would walk in from school and he would be gone and he would stay gone for days.
I had a lot of voids to fill. I went after the only thing I thought that could fill it, and that was boys.
But the whole time I was going to church acting like nothing was happening at home. But I realized how sick my dad was when he would go to church and praise Jesus and go home and get high.
I was brought up in church. My mom is a singer and my dad is a preacher. Brought up in the Church of God. But I lived it one day and the other day I didn't. I was a hypocrite.
I led a party lifestyle until I ended up pregnant at 14 years old.
I thought I could manage it, but as the days went by, I found myself consumed.
I went to an event called Winterfest, and I ended up meeting a girl that eventually I ended up asking to marry me. I fell in love with her. Soon after I asked her to marry me, we were in a car accident. She was killed right in front of my face.
I became sexually active at a young age because of what I saw in the videos.
When I was 8 years old, my mom took me and my brother and left. During this time, we would go see my dad, and he would take pills, shoot up, and drink, and do drugs just to get through the day.
I had my baby girl at 15 years old. At 16, I got married to her father. Everything was great. Everything was wonderful. We started out life right. We actually got saved, gave our life to Jesus. And then 4 years later, he relapsed.
It got so bad, I watched my daddy put a needle in his arm. He wasn't even trying to hide it from me anymore.
So later on in life, my parents got a divorce, which led to me getting angry at God for a lot of unanswered questions.
I was mad at God. I was mad at the world. I figured if he's supposed to love me so much, why'd he take her away from me? I got into the party lifestyle. I chased women. I thought if I could just pile as many women on top of the problem as I can, it'd make me feel better. But it didn't. It just drug me down.
Unfortunately, these were the last memories I had of my dad, because 7 months later, he overdosed and died. After that, I struggled with deep depression and hurt from men. I didn't trust any man because I was afraid they would hurt me like my dad did.
I did a lot of stupid stuff to fill the voids, but in the end, I found that Jesus Christ is the only one that can fill them for me, and he set me free.
And then one day, I had gone to a church service, and I had hit rock bottom. I had nowhere else to go. And the Holy Spirit had tugged at my heart so much to the point that I could not resist him any longer. And I ran up to that altar and I slid into it like it was home plate. And there was just such a spirit of love, and Jesus Christ came in and he set me free.
My husband's addiction eventually forced me and my children to have to leave him. It also caused him to overdose and die. And if I didn't have Jesus, I wouldn't have made it. Jesus Christ came into my life and he set me free.
One day, my mama brought me to an Eddie James concert, and the Spirit of God broke into my life and set me free from depression and fear of men. Now I can truly love my stepdad and trust him like I was intended to, because Jesus Christ set me free.